Welcome back to my channel. So first, if you are new to my channel, hey, how are you? Please hit that subscribe button. Make sure you like this video and also check out more of my videos on my channel. I'll have a playlist of my different playlists down below. So today is how I transitioned to natural and without doing the big chop. So I decided to go natural in August of 2017, September of 2017. I didn't want to get a relaxer anymore. It's just too much of an upkeep. I was getting sew-ins anyway, so I was like, what's the point? So I didn't do the big chop. It took me 2 years to fully transition. I didn't want to do the big chop because I had long hair. I can show you a picture of that here. I've always kind of had long hair and I didn't want to lose the length. I didn't want a bob. I didn't want a cut like this. So this is my hair slick back. So I will show you my hair of when I first took it out and I saw my curls or whatever. I'll show you that now. And I just didn't want to lose my length, and I didn't at all. And I wanted to get color, and the most healthiest way to get color. Relaxer plus color is a no-no. And so here are my tips. I have 5 tips of how I transition and how my hair is still healthy and it's still well kept and well maintenance, because I don't get my hair done often, but when I do, I like to get treatments and I like to get my hair trimmed. But anyways, number 1, protective styling. Throughout this journey of transitioning, I had braids. I've done braid outs, twist outs, my slick back bun. This was like my go-to hairstyle when I was transitioning. High buns, slick my hair up. I don't know if I have a video of my hair in high bun. I'll show you guys the different protective stylings I did. Wigs and sew-ins. The thing about protective styling is it causes you to not manipulate your hair so much, or put your hands in your hair, or do things to your hair, or anything like that. The easiest protective style that I did was probably braids, of course. Yeah, braids, but I can't keep braids in too long because my hair is soft, so my hair is soft, and so hold on, my daughter's sleeping, I had to listen. Okay, but my hair is soft, so braids it'll pop my hair out. So I love doing sew-ins. I probably did sew-ins a lot too, you know, but sew-ins can be expensive, you know, buying the hair, getting the hair done, you know, it can be expensive. But the cheapest alternative is definitely slick back buns, braid outs. All I did was use Eco Styler Gel. Sorry, I got a text message. But anyways, my slick back bun was probably my favorite. One of my favorites. Did I say everything was my favorite? Child? Anyways, like now I could do a video on how I do my slick back buns. I have like 4 or 5. Hair ties in my hair to make it so slick. But yes, so protective styling is so important. It causes you to not bother your hair, touch your hair, or whatever. So next, low manipulation to your hair. I have my notes right here. Lowest manipulation to your hair. And this kind of goes hand in hand with protective styling. Please just don't be digging in your hair a lot, or, you you know, combing your hair a lot. I don't do that unless I'm have wash day and I have to detangle and stuff like that. So yeah, I don't like to do a lot of manipulation on my hair because it just, I feel like if you irritate it too much, it'll start breaking off and falling out. Don't put a lot of heat on your hair. I straighten my hair maybe 3-4 times a year. And if I, most of the time when I do, it's because I have a professional doing it. Keep your hands out your hair as much as possible. I'm reading my notes. Just keep your hands out of your hair as much as possible. Like, yes, treat your hair weekly, every week. Or if you, some people like to do every 2 weeks. My hair can handle every 2 weeks. And it grows like a weed. So I can show you my length. I don't think I have a picture of my length. My hair is pretty, it's probably bra strap right now. Right now my hair is bra strap. Because it's been a journey. You know, from having my hair, you know, natural. But as leave it alone. Just let it grow. And honestly, transitioning is so difficult because of the different curl patterns. Your hair is curly like up here and then straight right here. So detangling is annoying. So it just makes it frustrating and it makes you just not even want to do it. So just leave your hair alone. If you let your hair, you know, grow and be great, it'll grow and be great. Okay, number 3. Deep condition your hair. You have to deep condition your hair. My 2 favorite deep conditioners was the Shea Moisture. I wish I had it. I think I might. The Shea Moisture Strengthen. Give me 1 second. I might still have it. I do. So the deep conditioners I like to use was the Jamaican Black Castor Oil from Shea Moisture. And it has shea butter, peppermint, and apple cider vinegar. For some reason, my hair does really good with peppermint. Really, 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 really good with peppermint. I leave this on sometimes. I'll leave it on all day. I put a plastic cap on. Put a plastic cap on. Or if you don't have a plastic cap, a plastic bag. And I let that thing sit in my hair, child. Yes, I do. I let it sit in my hair and just get in there. Moisturize. Because I have really dry hair and I have a dry scalp. So, honey, keep that thing in there and it'll do its job. And another, I'm almost out of this, like completely almost out. The Miel Babasu and Mint. Like I said, my hair does good with mint. Deep conditioner. And it's a protein treatment. Protein is so important in your hair. Do not use this every week, though. Your hair don't need protein every week, okay? Maybe once a month, give or take. But this, I swear by it, still to this day, if I feel my hair is, like, dry and, you know, it needs the extra little oomph, honey, that's what I do. And I'm not a, you know, specialist with hair. This is just what I do and this is what I did. And this, if my curls are like ugh or blah after, you know, a while or after washing it, I put this in my hair and I let this thing sit for a while. And so if you want a little razzle dazzle, put a hot like a dryer. I have what my puff looks like now and after I use this. Oh god, this is just, it's love. It's legit love. Okay, number 4. Keep your hair moisturized. Keep your hair moisturized. It doesn't matter what type of moisture products you use, keep your hair moisturized. I like to use Cantu. The Cantu Moisture. I forgot what it's called. This, the Cantu Leave-In Conditioning Cream. Repairs hair breakage. Leaves hair soft and manageable. It's true, it leaves my hair so soft and manageable. When I do braid outs, this is, it gives me a lot of definition with that, and also it leaves my hair so soft and moisturized, and my hair needs moisture. It's so dry. It's so dry if I don't do anything to it. So, honey, this is love. Oils, olive oil. I like using olive oil on my skin and my hair. Coconut oil, black castor oil, whatever type of oils you like. Pre-poo treatments. And to keep your hair moisturized, and also with deep conditioning, I like to use pre-poo treatment. It's the Design Essential. The peppermint, I told you, my hair does good with peppermint. Peppermint and aloe. So that's what I like to use for my hair. Before I use this, either the night before you wash your hair or hours before you wash your hair, let that seep into your scalp. And it's the peppermint alloy soothing scalp tonic, purifying, detoxifying, immediate itch relief, oil absorbing, ideal for use under hair extensions, wigs, braids, and other protective styles. But I use this as a pre-poo treatment and it does so good on my hair. And even if your hair is just dry, say you're wearing a wig and you have a braid down or whatever, or you have, you know, like it says for sew-ins, throw that thing in there and it'll just and massage it. You have to massage it in your scalp. Yes, but keep your hair moisturized. A lot of people use that LOC method, I think that's what it's called. I don't know what it is, but I don't. I think it's liquid leave-in, I think. Oil and cream, I think. But I don't, you know, I'm not a professional. This is just what works for me and it does good for my hair. My hair is growing very well. Yes, and finally, be patient. That's it. Be patient. It's gonna take some time. Unless you want to chop it off. If you want to chop it off, girl, you know, be great. But honey, I wasn't gonna do that.
Sorry, I didn't catch that. Try tapping above.
Girl, stop. Boy, stop. Be patient. I wasn't gonna do that. My head is too big to be bald, so I wasn't gonna do that. I wasn't planning on showing the products that I use, but these are just some staples in my routine that I still use, and I started using because I was transitioning and I was learning about my hair. That's what it is. It's a process, and it's you learning what works for your hair. It's a lot, and it takes a lot of time, and you know, it's effort. It honestly is. It's effort, but once you do it, you are going to love it. Like, don't do it because you see other people going natural. Don't do it because, oh, this and that. I was tired of relaxers, and I knew my hair, I wanted to see my hair pattern, and I knew I had curly hair, and that I do. And I have a wash and go routine. That was like my first wash and go ever, so it's not the best, but it's what I do, and it shows you my curl pattern, so I'll leave it in the eye card. But yes, be patient. It's gonna take time. It takes time, okay? It takes time. It takes patience. And even if you do the big chop, it's gonna take time for your hair to grow back. It is what it is. It's just being patient. But I wanted to preserve as much hair. Oh, and you have to trim regularly. Like, every time if your ends are straggly, cut them off. I had to go get some shears. I had to learn how to trim my own ends. The last time when I became natural, I cut 2 inches off my hair. And you couldn't really tell, but you cut 2 inches off your hair and I still had hair down my back. So it takes time. You can preserve your hair. You don't have to lose all of your hair to become natural. You don't. So tomorrow I'll film my hair routine. I'm washing my hair. And oh, really good products, Design Essentials Natural. Very good products for your hair. That's probably what I'm using tomorrow, so I'll show you guys, but very good. And what I'm gonna do is, I'm probably gonna do a braid out because it's just easier for my hair. I have pretty curls, but they don't always wanna act right. So I braid out. Makes it easier. So yes, thank you guys so much for watching this video. Please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to my channel to see more hair videos, makeup videos. I have a series on my channel called Raising Ryan. I haven't done it in a while, and I have footage. I just haven't gotten around to editing it. Yeah. So please subscribe, and please keep up and turn your post notifications on as well. I'm gonna get back into the swing of posting and editing and doing these videos more often. So yes, I'm excited. And if you have any questions, leave them down below. I'm very good about responding to comments. And yes, thank you guys so much for watching this video, and I hope to see you